So we'll get started guys. I hope you guys prepared short notes on the formula which I told you. Right? You would have revisited your 11th standard textbook and made a short notes of all the formula. Right? Are you able to hear me first?
Yes, sir.
So listen. So 11th was the last problem that we did yesterday. Oh, these are all example problems, so sorry.
We did 13th, sir, as the last problem.
13th, huh?
Yes, sir.
Ah, 13th is what we did, yeah. Yes. So 14th we'll start with. Listen. So, if sine of sine inverse 1 by 5 plus cos inverse of x is equal to 1, then the value of x is how much? It's a very simple problem again. Solution is sine of sine inverse of 1 by 5 plus cos inverse of x is equal to 1. So, sine of, so I'll take sine inverse on both sides. Taking sine inverse on both sides, I will get sine inverse of 1 by 5 plus cos inverse of x is equal to sine inverse of 1. Sine inverse of 1 is possible for what angle? Pi by 2. Right? So sine inverse of 1 by 5, or else I will do it like this. See, actually, can you guys tell me the answer? By now you should have found it out. Pi by 2 minus sine inverse of 1 by 5. So property number 4, pi by 2 minus sine inverse of 1 by 5 is cos inverse of 1 by 5. So what is the value of x?
It will be 1 by 5.
It is 1 by 5. So that's the answer. Done. Next. So if tan inverse of x minus 1 by x minus 2 plus tan inverse of x plus 1 by x plus 2 is equal to pi by 4, find the value of x. You guys tell me, no? Solution. So tan inverse of x plus y. So tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus x into y. This is equal to pi by 4. So tan inverse of, if I take LCM, what am I going to get? X minus 1 into x plus 2 plus x plus 1 into x minus 2, the whole divided by x square minus 4 minus of x square minus 1. The denominators will get cancelled. Okay, so x minus 1 into x minus 2 is x square plus x minus 2 plus x square minus x minus 2 divided by x square minus 4 minus x square plus 1 is equal to tan inverse of pi by 4 means, so tan inverse of something is equal to pi by 4. So tan inverse will go that side, answer will be 1, because tan pi by 4 is 1. Okay, if you want, I will write another step, tan pi by 4. So what will get cancelled here? X and x are gone. So 2x square minus 4 divided by x square gone, minus 3 is equal to 1. So 2x square minus 4 is equal to minus 3, which implies 2x square is equal to how much? 1. So x square is equal to half, which implies x is equal to plus or minus 1 divided by root 2. Plus or minus 1 divided by root 2. I hope everyone is able to understand.
Sir.
Okay. Shall I move on to the next one? Solution. You want me to show something?
So last part.
Your voice is breaking. Yeah. Yes, have sir, a doubt or you want
completed.
To
note? I wanted noted. It's completed.
Okay. So solution. Sine of 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3. Right? That's it, no?
So actually, it should be in the range of minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So we have to split it.
Yes, because 2 pi by 3 falls in which quadrant? I was expecting it. Which quadrant? It is 120 degrees, no? 120 degrees falls in the second quadrant. For sine inverse, the value should be in the first and the fourth quadrant. So sine of 2 pi by 3, instead I told you a technique, no? 2 by 3, if this is the fraction, if the numerator is less than the denominator, what are you supposed to do? Write the numerator in terms of denominator. 3 pi.
It should be pi minus pi by 3. Sir.
Yes, it should be pi minus pi by 3. So it is sine inverse of sine of pi minus pi by 3. If anyone is having a problem with these kind of problems, do let me know. If you have issues with these kind of problems, I'll give you some more problems for practice. So sine inverse of sine pi by 3, which will be pi by 3. Now it is accepted because pi by 3 is in the range of minus pi by 2 to pi by 3. Right?
Yes, sir.
find the value of tan inverse of 3 pi by 4. So tan inverse of tan of 3 pi by 4. I cannot write it as 3 pi by 4. Is not equal to 3 pi by 4 since 3 pi by 4 does not belong to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So what am I supposed to do?
To split it, sir.
So numerator is less than the denominator.
Pi minus pi by 4.
Very good. It will be pi minus pi by 4 because it is 4 pi minus pi by 4. So pi minus pi by 4. So tan inverse of tan of Surya, are there?
Yes, sir, I'm there.
You are able to understand?
Yes, sir.
The reason I'm asking is because you brought this issue to me. Now you're clear, no? Why it is pi minus pi by 4?
Yes, sir.
Good. So tan of pi minus pi by 4 is minus tan pi by 4. Correct, Ada? Because tan pi minus theta is minus tan theta.
Yes,
because
tan, in yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Second quadrant, tan is negative. Right? So tan inverse of minus of tan pi by 4 is minus 1. Now go to property number 2. To the radar, tan inverse of minus x. It is minus tan inverse.
Just tan inverse.
Yes, sir.
Minus tan inverse of 1 is minus pi by 4. Clear? So this is the requirement. Since tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse of x. Okay. Next. Find the expression, find the value of expression tan of sine inverse 3 by 5 plus cot inverse 3 by 2. So what am I supposed to do? When they say expression, the value, I need to get rid of the tan of the trigonometric function. So for that, what I will do is sine inverse of 3 pi by 5, I will write it in terms of tan inverse. So sine inverse of 3 by 5 is tan inverse of how much? Draw the right angle triangle, tell me. Find all those values and
3 by 4. Sir.
Very good. 3 by 4. Similarly, cot inverse of 3 by 2 is tan inverse of, this is easy. Cot inverse x is tan inverse of 1st property. Cot inverse of 3 by 2 is tan inverse of
2 by 3.
You need to draw the triangle. Cot inverse x is equal to tan inverse of 1 by x. This is the reciprocal. Right? So, tan of sine inverse of 3 by 5 plus cot inverse of 3 by 2 will be equal to tan of tan inverse of 3 by 4 plus tan inverse of 2 by 3. Tell me what is the value of this term. Tan of tan inverse of x plus y, that is 3 by 4 plus 2 by 3 divided by 1 minus 3 by 4 into 2 by 3. So tan of tan inverse of 9 plus 8 divided by 12 minus 6. So it will be tan of tan inverse of 17 divided by how much? 6. So what will be the answer?
17 by 6.
Because tan of tan inverse of x is x for all values of x that belongs to R. So make a note. Next, cos inverse of cos 7 pi by 6. Here observe, the numerator is greater than the denominator, still you are going to write it in terms of the denominator only. So cos inverse of cos of 7 pi by 6, tell me guys. So cos inverse of cos of 7 pi by 6, I can write it as 6 pi plus pi divided by 6, right? So cos inverse of cos of, it is pi plus pi by 6. How much is cos of pi plus pi by 6? Which quadrant? Cos of pi plus theta.
Yes, it's positive only, sir. So cos pi by 6.
Minus cos pi. Third quadrant, right? Third quadrant cos is negative.
Pi by 6 is in first quadrant.
Pi plus the. Pi is 0, pi. 180 plus 2 times is third quadrant. Third quadrant cos is negative. So what is minus, what is cos pi by 6 value? It is minus half. Minus half, minus root 3 by 2, sorry.
Root 3 by
2. Minus root 3 by 2. So cos inverse of minus x is pi minus of cos inverse of x. So pi minus, what is the value of cos inverse of root 3 by 2? That is pi by 6. So pi minus pi by 6 is pi pi by 6. Are you clear with the way you are supposed to show the steps?
Yes, sir. Clear.
So you need to show all these steps.
We have to use the which property. We have to show which property we used, right?
You need not
like
write
second
it as,
property here.
You not write it as property 2, property 3, not like that. Rather, you should write what the property is. We know that cos inverse of minus x is pi minus of cos inverse of x. I'm using the reference number for you guys to answer. Don't
okay,
write
sir,
it.
I understood.
Don't write it like that. Okay.
Yes, I understood.
Moving on to the next problem. Sine of pi by 3 minus sine inverse of minus half. Sine of pi by 3 minus. What is the value of sine inverse of minus half, guys? Is it not minus sine inverse half? Right, no? Because sine inverse of minus half is minus sine inverse. Minus of minus will become plus. Sine half is pi by 6. Pi by 3 is 60 degrees. Pi by 6 is 30 degrees. Sine pi by 3 plus pi by 6 is sine pi by 2. Sine pi by 2 is 1. Tell me, tan inverse root 3 minus cot inverse of minus root 3. Tan inverse root 3 is how much? Pi by
3.
Very good. Minus cot inverse of minus x is how much?
Pi minus cot inverse x.
Very good. So it is pi by 3 minus pi, pi by 3 minus of pi minus, what is cot inverse of root 3? That is pi by 6. Correct? So pi by 3 yes. Minus of 5 pi by 6. Take LCM. So 2 pi, so it will be minus 3 pi by 6 and it is minus pi by 2. Clear? Okay. That's it. We are done with this exercise. Okay. Actually, this chapter is over. But we'll do miscellaneous also, for there are some good problems in it. So I'm doing the examples of miscellaneous exercise. Show that sine inverse of 12 by 13 plus cos inverse of 4 by 5 plus tan inverse of 63 by 16 is a pi. Simple. So the only formula that you know is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. So what is our work? To convert sine inverse.
Convert everything into tan.
Convert everything to tan. So sine inverse of 12 by 13 is tan inverse of how much? Take a right angle triangle. I take this as theta, this is 12, this is 13. So how much will be the other angle?
It will be 12 by 5.
5, sir. 12 by 5.
It is 12 by 5 because 5, 12, 13 are Pythagorean triplet. Similarly, cos inverse of 4 by 5 will be tan inverse 5 of? 5
by
3.
3 by 4.
3 by 4.
3 by 4.
Because 3, 4, 5 are Pythagorean triplets. So tan inverse of 63 by 16, I need not disturb. So if I add these two, that is tan inverse of 12 by 5 plus tan inverse of 3 by 4 is how much term?
Tan inverse 12 by 5 plus 3 by 4 by 1 minus 12 by 5 into 3 by 4.
Okay, so how much will that give you? Tan inverse of 48 plus 15 divided by
8. 20.
20 minus 36. So minus tan inverse of how much? 48 plus 15 is how much? 63. Did I miss anything? 20 minus 63 divided by minus 16. Okay. So tan inverse of minus 63 by 16 plus tan inverse of 63 by 16. It should actually give you a zero. What are they asking? Show that this is this thing. Actually, the value should be zero.
Even if you add all, it will be zero, right, sir?
Yes, it should be. That is what the answer is supposed to be. Minus tan in. See, because tan inverse of minus x is what? It is minus tan inverse x.
Minus tan inverse x. So it will be zero, sir, when we add both.
It should be zero. But 1 minute. 1 minute. There should be a logic for it. See, miscellaneous, what they do know, they concentrate more on the domain. So now see what they happen. It's for all values of x that belongs to. See, there are two ways to prove, okay? It can either be zero, but see, but I can show you how to get a pi, but it is a forced way of getting it. So what I'm going to do is tan inverse of minus 63 by 16, I will write it as cot inverse of 16 by 63 with the minus sign. Okay. Plus this thing is what? This is cot inverse of 16 divided by 63. Now what is cot inverse of minus x? This pi minus of cot inverse of 16 divided by 63. Plus you have cot inverse of 16 by 63. You cancel these two, you get it as pi. But I'm not sure why they are specific in this problem that it should be a pi. the answer can be a zero also, because there is no restriction with respect to domain.
So
what I would suggest is, since they asked you to prove, I would suggest in the last do this step and show. That's it.
Okay, sir.
Because I hope you guys are able to understand, there is no restriction on the domain itself. Because tan inverse of minus 63 by 16 would directly give me minus tan inverse of 63 by 16, because 63 by 16 falls to the real number set. That's what the property says, x belongs to R. But it's a forced way of proving, no other option, do it. Okay. Am I clear, guys?
Clear, sir.
So we'll move on to the next one. So 12th one, this was a good problem. Tan inverse of A cos x minus B sin x by B cos x plus A sin x. See, whenever you have this tan inverse of, in the bracket you will have a combination of cos and sin in the numerator and cos and sin in the denominator. That time what you are supposed to do is try to convert everything in terms of tan. That is the logic. So if I have sin x in my hand, what is the logic I need to use to convert it to cos x? I mean, tan
cos x divided by cos x.
You have to divide and multiply it with cos x. Okay. But if I look at this problem, in addition to sin x existing, there is A and B combination also. There are some coefficients also. Then I need to smartly choose one thing. Okay. What I will do is, I will divide the numerator and denominator with B cos x. Okay.
So why B, sir?
Why B cos x? Because, see, tan inverse of, I should be able to get this in the form tan of A, see, this is it. I am doing a reverse operation here. Tan A plus tan B by, it is like this actually, tan A minus tan B by 1 plus tan A tan B. What is this, guys? Is it not tan of A minus
tan
B? Okay, so if I look, if I have to get tan of something from this, then look at the formula. I need to have a 1 here. Correct? So if I need to have a 1 here, what is it I am supposed to divide with? I need to divide it with B cos x. That's the logic.
Okay, sir. Understood.
Okay. So divide numerator and denominator with B cos x. If I do that, what will I get? Tan inverse of A by B minus tan x by 1 plus A by B into tan x. You guys can do it. I skipped one step in between. I hope you guys understood this. Right? Is anyone having a confusion? You want me to show the intermediate step? Sorry? No need,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
That's clear. Good. Now see, I need tan A minus tan B by 1 plus tan B. What I will do is, I will take A by B as tan alpha. I will take A by B as tan alpha. Then what will I get? Alpha is nothing but tan inverse of A by B. Have this in your mind. So tan inverse of tan alpha minus tan x divided by 1 plus tan alpha into tan x. Tell me now. Tan inverse of tan of
tan minus tan b,
tan of alpha minus x. So tan inverse of tan of alpha minus x is alpha minus x. But what is alpha? It is tan inverse of a by b minus x. So this is the simplified form. Okay. Okay, so I suggest you guys to practice these kind of problems. I give it to you in the assignment. Okay, you can practice these kind of problems. They are very good. Okay. So moving on to the next one. There is one more example. That is tan inverse of 2x plus tan inverse of 3x pi by 4. You are asked to solve, not to prove. So you should find the value of x. So it is going to be tan inverse of 2x plus 3x divided by 1 minus 6x square is pi by 4. So 5x divided by 1 minus 6x square will be equal to tan pi by 4. So tan pi by 4 is 1. 5x will be equal to 1 minus 6x square, which implies 6x square plus 5x plus 1 is equal to 0. So what will be the answer here? 6x square, minus 1 plus 6x minus x minus 1 is 0. So 6x into x plus 1 minus 1 into x plus 1 is equal to 0. 6x is equal to 1 or x is equal to minus 1. So x is 1 by 6 or minus 1. It can be anything because it is within tan inverse. X belongs to R, no? Okay. But what we can do is we will try to resubstitute and check it. So you will get x is equal to 1 by 6 or minus 1, no? So what is tan inverse of 2 into 1 by 6 plus tan inverse of 3 into 1 by 6? I'll get it as 3 here, I'll get it as 2 here. So tan inverse of 1 by 3 plus tan inverse of half. Can you guys solve this and tell me? So you'll get tan inverse of 5 by 6 divided by 1 minus 5 by 6 divided by 5 by 6. So you'll get tan inverse of 1, which is pi by 4. Okay. Whereas when you substitute x is equal to minus 1, what will happen is this will be a negative value. This will also be a negative value. Sum of two negative values can never be positive. Hence, minus 1 will not satisfy. So x is equal to 1 by 6 is the only solution. So in these kind of problems where they are asking you to solve, once you find the value, your work is to resubstitute it and validate whether the given equation is, whether the value is being satisfied in the question.
But that is for our satisfaction, right? It's not necessary in the answer.
It will not work in many cases. See, for example, I have seen problems where you will get the answer as 0 and 1. If you substitute it back, 1 will not work. It is not for our satisfaction. It is not for our satisfaction.
Okay, sir.
It's a mandatory thing. Okay. So the mandatory thing here you need to do is re-substitute the obtained values in the question.
Sir, can you explain the substitution part again?
This one should I explain? Substitution part, what I did is, we got x is equal to 1 by 6 or minus 1, no? This x is equal to 1 by 6, I substituted back in the question. So when I substitute, I'll get tan inverse of 2 into 1 by 6 plus tan inverse of 3 into 1 by 6. I got tan inverse 1 plus tan inverse half. When you solve this, on the LHS, you will get tan inverse of 5 by 6 divided by 5 by 6, which is pi by 4. So x is equal to 1 by 6 is satisfying. If I substitute minus 1 here, what would have happened? You would have got tan inverse of minus 2 plus tan inverse of minus 3. So this is minus tan inverse of 2 and this is minus tan inverse of 3. Sum of two negative values cannot be a positive value pi by 4. That is why minus 1 will not satisfy.
Okay, sir.
So that's it. So this is all about the example problems. Let's try out some miscellaneous problems. Just give me a minute. 24 na 17 problems are there. Okay, let's try to solve how many ever are possible today. Okay, first one, can we do little fast? Is everyone okay with the speed?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
See, I'm looking at cos inverse of cos 13 pi by 6. 13 pi by 6 does not belong to 0 to pi. So I need to convert it to a value less than 0 to pi. Numerator is greater than the denominator. What should I do? I should write the numerator close to the multiple of the denominator. So what are the multiple which is close to 13 pi? Multiple of 2 6? Pi. 2 pi. So cos inverse of cos of 12 pi plus pi by 6. So cos inverse of cos of 2 pi plus pi by 6. So 2 pi plus pi by 6 falls in which quadrant?
Third quadrant, sir.
Right.
First quadrant, sorry, sir.
First quadrant. 2 pi is one revolution plus pi by 6. So cos inverse of cos of pi by 6, right? Now it falls between 0 to pi. The answer will be pi by 6. Okay. So I want you all to do simultaneously with me. I'll be a little fast. If there is any doubt, please stop me, okay? So tan inverse of tan 7 pi by 6. 7 pi by 6 does not fall between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2. So what are we supposed to do? Tan inverse of numerator is greater than the denominator.
Pi
plus pi divided by 6. So tan inverse of tan of pi plus pi by 6. So tan inverse of tan of pi plus pi by 6. Third quadrant. Third quadrant tan is? The third quadrant positive. So it will be tan pi by 6. So what will be the answer? Tan inverse of tan of pi by 6 is pi by 6. Okay. Pi by 6. Now, 2 sine inverse of 3 by 5 is equal to tan inverse of 24 by 7. Okay. Solution. 2 times, or I will write it like this. Sine inverse of 3 by 5 is equal to tan inverse of how much? 3 by 4,
sir.
Okay. Now, 2 times sine inverse of 3 by 5 is equal to 2 times tan inverse of 3 by 4. So, what is the formula for 2 tan inverse of x? It is tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. Right? So, 2 tan inverse of 3 by 4 can be written as tan inverse of 2 into 3 by 4 divided by 1 minus 9 by 16. So tan inverse of 2 times. So 3 by 2 divided by 7 by 16. 8 times. 8 goes here. So you will get tan inverse of 24 divided by 7. Is that what they are asking? Yeah. Okay. Next. So prove that sine inverse of 8 by 17 plus sine inverse of 3 by 5 is tan inverse of 77 by 36. So idea.
You have to convert it to tan.
That's it. You guys can do it, no? I'll do the conversion alone. Calculation, you people do it. Tan inverse of 8 divided by 15. 8, 15 and 17 are Pythagorean triplets. Similarly, sine inverse of 3 by 4, 3 by 5 is tan inverse of 3 by 4. Add these two. When you add, you should get this. Okay. Next. The same logic. Cos inverse of 4 by 5 converted to tan. Cos inverse of 12 by 30 converted in terms of tan. Find the left hand side in terms of tan inverse. convert cos inverse 33 by 65 also in terms of tan inverse. Left hand side and right hand side should match. Okay, so this is nothing but tan inverse of 3 by 4. This one is tan inverse of 5 by 12. You add these two, you should be able to get. So you will get the answer in terms of tan inverse. If you want, you can convert it back into cos inverse also, so that you will get the right hand side without disturbing right hand side. You can do it. Clear? Similar homework. Similar. Yeah. This one, what are we supposed to do? So take two two values, solve them. You should get tan inverse of 1 at the end. Tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. So take the first two, tan inverse of 1 by 5 plus 1 by 7 divided by 1 minus 1 by 35 plus tan inverse of, take these two values, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 8 divided by 1 minus 1 by 24. So tan inverse of 12 by 35 by 34 by 35 plus tan inverse of 11 by 24 divided by 23 by 24. Cancel. Again, you will have tan inverse of 12 by 34 plus 11 by 23 divided by 1 minus 12 by 34 into 11 by 23. Solve for this. This should come out as tan inverse of 1, and the answer will be pi by 4. So that part you guys can do, right?
Yes, sir.
Actually, 12 by 34 can be simplified as 6 by 17 also. You can do that. It will be simple for you. We do some good problems, yeah. Ninth one, let's see. So I will solve this. Prove that tan inverse of root x is equal to half of cos inverse of 1 by x, 1 minus x by 1 plus x. It's a good one. So, tan inverse of root x is equal to half into cos inverse of 1 minus x divided by 1 plus x. Okay. Go to the property number 6 and tell me, how can 2 tan inverse x be written in terms of cos inverse?
Two tan inverse can be written as cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square.
So is it not something looking similar? 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. So it is not having x square, rather it is having only x. So cos inverse of 1 minus x divided by 1 plus x. So what I will do is I will put x is equal to tan square theta, because I know that cos 2 theta is 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. That implies tan theta is equal to root x, and that also implies theta is equal to tan inverse of root x. I didn't take plus or minus because they have clearly mentioned in the question that the value of x, it belongs to 0 to 1. So x is a positive value. So I didn't take it as plus or minus. Okay. So have this in your mind. So half into cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. How much is this now? Is it not cos inverse of cos 2 theta? So 1 by 2 into cos inverse of cos 2 theta is going to be 2 theta. 2 and 2 will get cancelled, which implies theta is equal to how much? Tan inverse of root x, and this is the LHS. Is there anyone having a doubt?
No doubts.
Good. So copy it. next part. Solution. I have cot inverse of root of 1 plus sin x plus root of 1 minus sin x by root of 1 plus sin x minus root of 1 minus sin x. Okay. So remember, you have a formula for 1 plus cos x and 1 minus cos x. And the formula in this chapter you are supposed to remember for 1 plus sin x is, listen to this carefully, okay? Sin square x by 2 plus cos square x by 2 my plus, can I write sin x as 2 sin x by 2 into cos x by 2? So this is like the form a square plus b square plus 2ab. So it is going to be cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 the whole square. There is a reason why I wrote cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 the whole square, because they gave the value of x where it belongs to 0 to pi by 4. If you take the trigonometric table and see, between 0 to pi by 4, cos will have a greater value compared to sin. Okay? So that is the reason why I wrote. So in the case of cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2, it doesn't make any difference. Whereas in the case of 1 minus sin x, what will happen? You will have cos square x by 2 plus sin square x by 2 minus 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2. No? So this place, it will be cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 the whole square. Guys, are you able to understand this point?
Yes, sir.
Now comes an important point. That is, cot inverse of, wherever I have root of 1 plus sin x, so if I take the square root, what is going to happen? Then what will have be the value of root of 1 plus sin x? That will be cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2. Root of 1 minus sin x is cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2. Okay. So cot inverse of, you guys tell me. Cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 plus cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 the whole divided by cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 minus cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2. Clear? So sin x by 2, sin x by 2 will get cancelled. Cos x by 2 and cos x by 2 will get cancelled. What is that you are left out with? Cot inverse of cos x by 2 divided by sin x by 2. So cot inverse of cot of x by 2. What is the answer? It is x by 2, and that is what they have asked us to prove. Done?
Yes, sir.
No, tell me. 11th one. Tan inverse of root of 1 plus x minus root of 1 minus x divided by root of 1 plus x plus root of 1 minus x is equal to pi by 4 minus 1 by 2 into cos inverse of x. They have given a hint, put x is equal to cos 2 theta. Even if the hint is not given, how to find, you need to put cos 2 theta is, this cos inverse x is telling you. See, had the question been like this, pi by 4 minus cos inverse x, then you will put x as cos theta. If it is half into cos inverse x, then you will put x as cos 2 theta. Had it been 1 by 4 into cos inverse x, you would have put x as cos
So could you repeat?
How much will you? I'm saying, had the question been like this, right side, 5/4 minus cos inverse x, then the hint is, you need to put x as cos theta. Had the question been 5/4 minus half cos inverse x, then the hint is, you will put x is equal to cos 2 theta. Had it been 5/4 minus 1/4 into cos inverse x, the hint would have been, put x is equal to
cos 4 theta.
Okay, so it is not necessary that they need to give you a hint. So when I put x is equal to cos 2 theta, I know that 1 plus cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square theta. Taking all these values and substituting here, what will we get? We will get tan inverse of root of 1 plus cos 2 theta minus root of 1 minus cos 2 theta, the whole divided by root of 1 plus cos 2 theta plus root of 1 minus cos 2 theta. Correct? So tan inverse of root of 1 plus cos 2 theta will be how much? Is it not root 2 cos theta minus, this will be root 2 sin theta divided by root 2 cos theta plus root 2 sin theta. So what you get cancelled, root 2 is gone. So whenever you have the combination of tan inverse and cosine, what are we supposed to do? Divide the numerator and denominator with this
by
value.
Cos.
By this value, whatever is here, you have to divide it with that. So when you divide it, you will get 1 minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan theta. So tan inverse of 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta, I've already told you. It is tan of 5/4 minus theta. So tan inverse of tan of 5/4 minus theta is 5/4 minus theta, that is 5/4 minus. What is the value of theta, guys? You have put x is equal to cos 2 theta. So 2 theta is equal to cos inverse of x. Theta will be half of cos inverse of x. So 5/4 minus half of cos inverse of x. So I hope you got the answer. Okay. Shall we go to the next one? So solution is, the question 5/8 minus 9/4 into sine inverse 1/3 is to be proved that it is equal to 9/4 into sine inverse of 2√2/3. Okay. So let me take the LHS. 9π/8 minus 9/4 into sine inverse of 1/3. Okay. So what is common in both? 9/4, pi by 2 minus sine inverse of 1/3. Any doubt till this step?
No, sir.
Property number 4, pi by 2 minus sine inverse x. Cos inverse of 1/3. Right?
Yes, sir.
So cos inverse of 1/3 means, if I take this as theta, 1/3, then how much will this angle be? Root of 9 minus 1, it is root 8. Root 8 is nothing but 2√2. So 9/4 into cos inverse of 1/3 is same as sine inverse of how much? Look at the right angle triangle and tell me. 2√2 divided by 3. That's what they asked. right? There are actually five more problems: 23, 25, 27, 29, 31. Six problems.
Could you show the sum again for a minute?
Any doubt?
No doubts. I just want to make a note.
Okay.
So here at 2 root 2, if we convert sine inverse to cos inverse, it will be 1 by 3, right? So we don't have to show that step, converting it into cos inverse. We can leave it in sine inverse.
Because you got the answer in cos inverse. Since the answer is expected in terms of sine inverse, you converted cos inverse. The answer is expected.
Okay, sir. I understood. Yes, yeah. I understood.
Yeah.
Done, sir.
Yeah. So solve the equation for x. 2 tan inverse of cos x is equal to, so there is an equation, guys, don't be in a hurry to prove, okay? So when they say solve, you need to find the value of x. So 2 tan inverse of cos x, okay, 2 tan inverse of cos x is equal to tan inverse of 2 cosecant x. So 2 tan inverse of cos x, 2 tan inverse of x in terms of tan inverse. Tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. Sorry. Correct? Because 2 tan inverse x is equal to tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. In the place of x, you have cos x here. So 2 cos x by 1 minus cos square x. This is equal to tan inverse of 2 cosecant x. So tan inverse of 2 cos x divided by, how much is this? You will get it as sine square x is equal to tan inverse of 2 cosecant x. Now, since both sides are tan inverse, I can say 2 cos x by sine square x is equal to 2 cosecant x. So cos x is equal to sine square x into cosecant x. How much will you get? You will get sin x. So sin x divided by cos x is equal to 1, which implies tan x is equal to 1. So what will be the value of x? It is tan inverse of 1 or pi by 4. Okay. So since in this case you got only one value, you need not verify, but in this case for your satisfaction you can verify and see. So 2 times tan inverse of cos pi by 4, how much is it? 2 tan inverse, you will not get it, 1 by root 2. Okay, let it be like this. What is tan inverse of 2 cosecant x? Cosecant pi by 4, that is tan inverse of 2 root 2. So now what you can do is you can try to verify this and see. 2 tan inverse of half is tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. Do and see. You will get tan inverse of 2 root 2. Okay. This you need not show in the exam. You can write the value of x as pi by 4 and leave it. Okay. Clear? So we'll do one last problem and then we'll wind up. So tan inverse of 1 minus x by 1 plus x is equal to half into tan inverse x. This is also solve the equation. Okay. What you can do is take the 2 to the other side. Or the best way is, you can always do substitution method also. You can put x is equal to tan theta. Okay. First find out theta. Once you get the value of theta, substitute it here. That will give you the value of x. Okay. Well. So tan inverse of 1 minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan theta is equal to half into tan inverse of tan theta. So how much is this term? Tan inverse of 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta is tan of
pi by 4 minus.
Very good. Pi by 4 minus theta. This is equal to half into, this is theta. So tan inverse of tan pi by 4 minus theta is pi by 4 minus theta is equal to theta by 2. So pi by 4 will be equal to 3 theta by 2. Cancel it. So theta will be how much? Pi by 6. But we know that x is equal to tan theta, that is equal to tan pi by 6. Answer will be 1 by root 3. Okay.
So can you explain that tan pi by 4 minus theta's difference?
No, we have solved it in many problems. No? 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta, wherever you see this going forward, by default it is tan pi by 4 minus theta because expanded.
Like a formula, sir.
Formula. We have been using till now. Yeah. So 1 by 3, 1 by root 3 is the answer. Let me see how they are solved. They are also substituted. So that's the easiest way. See, when I looked at this problem, no, I got this idea also. I'll take 2 to the other side, 2 to the other side. I will convert 2 tan inverse to tan inverse and then solve. But it's a tedious process because 1 minus x by 1 plus x is a big value to handle. Okay, so I think 4 more problems are left, 29, 31, 33, 3 more problems are left. Those 3 problems you guys can solve. So officially this chapter is over. Okay, so tomorrow I'll be starting a new chapter. As I told you previously and on the induction day, on the day of induction, I'll be concentrating more on the tougher parts in the beginning. Most of your students have started matrices and determinants. But I believe that those are chapters which can be handled with the school lectures. Is there any, if there is any difficulty, please let me know. I'm trying to record those sessions of matrices and determinants. I will try to do it before May 15th and give it to you so that you can go through during the holidays. Okay. So tomorrow's class, I'll be starting continuity and differentiability because calculus carries 35 marks. Until now, we have completed out of 80 marks from your course, we have completed 8 marks. Okay, these two chapters put together is for 8 marks. Next is the major portion, that is calculus. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, see you guys.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.